Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here. Today is November 2nd, 2013. People, today I'm going to bring you all this video, right? What you're looking at is a surveillance camera of the Brockton Police Department in Brockton, Massachusetts. In this video, people, I'm going to show you all the police officer caught red-handed, stealing my money. The cops, they said they set up a sting operation. The guy that knew the cop was stealing people's money. So people, in this video, right, I'm going to prove to you guys, no one have seen this video. No one in public have seen this video. The news have not seen this video. Show it to you guys. You see that gun, that cop with that gun right there? That gun was for me. Anyway, they arrested me on May 1st, 2012. And the cop stole my money. And in this video, I'm going to show you all police brutality. I'm gonna show you all, not only did the cop steal my money on camera, but that another cop also tried to break my wrist. Okay, police brutality for no reason. Religious prosecution, religious prejudice. He violated my First Amendment right to freedom of expression. But before I show you guys that, right, before I show you all the police caught stealing, let me show you all the news about how the police got caught. And then I'm going to tell you all the story of my arrest, okay? So, bear with me a second. Let me show you all what they say about the cops stealing people's money. Okay, people, I'm going to show you all three short stories, right? This one here is from police thugs. Cops who break the law, abuse your power, or just act like straight-up thugs. Okay. Cop accused of stealing cash from those he arrested. July 18, 2012. This is the cop right here, people. See his face? Remember that face, okay? Okay. Here you go. A Brockton police officer appeared in court Wednesday, accused of stealing money from people who were under arrest. The officer, Michael Sullivan, allegedly stole money from people at Brockton police headquarters while they were in the booking room. Authorities say there were at least 8 incidents where Sullivan stole money. Court papers say he manipulated the bills and that his actions were so quick and deliberate that it was clear his actions were in no way a mistake. People, it is true. Wait till you all see the video. This guy is so quick. Okay? He is so quick, but he got caught. Okay, so that's one story right there. Read another one. Police misconduct, USA and the Fairfax County Police. Where the hell is the US Justice Department? Why don't they do something to stop mean cops? Arrested cop Sullivan said to be caught on tape. So people, he was caught on tape. I'm going to show you all the tape. The complaint came from a citizen to police. Brockton Police Officer Michael E. Sullivan, while on duty and in uniform at a police station, had taken a sum of money from a victim, court documents show. That incident in March captured on police department security cameras launched an internal investigation by police. Police Chief Emmanuel Gomez said, on Wednesday, police department security cameras captured Sullivan on duty and in uniform at a police station taking another sum of money, this time from an undercover police officer, court documents show. Police use an undercover police officer who is not from this area as part of the internal investigation, so he will not be known, Gomez said. Okay. The last one. After accused of stealing cash at Brockton PD. Okay, this is what I'm gonna cut to the chase. This is what the guy who set him up said. He did the booking and I pull out my wallet and they start counting out cash while asking another question. The property officer, if I remember right, he turned to me and said, you have about $100 here, said Michael Smith, a victim. But Michael Smith said that was wrong. Smith said he had $140 and he knew one of the officers who was involved in booking him had stolen the $40. Smith was arrested on a motor vehicle charge and spent a night in jail. I am saying if I bring it up to another any officer walking by or anything, they're going to put the money back, Smith said. Smith finally blew the whistle and an internal investigation was launched at the Brockton Police Department. As a result, Officer Michael Sullivan, 54, was charged. He's accused of stealing small bills from people arrested who were brought to police headquarters. So people, they did not mention that he got caught stealing my money also, but that's okay because what people don't have, I have. I have the video. So let's go back to the video. First, I'm gonna show you all, I'm in this car right here. They have me in that car right there. Because people, it was a chase, okay? They came to arrest me and I jumped out my second floor window and I jumped a couple of fences. And I told the cops to shoot me. I was running and yelling, shoot me, shoot me, shoot me. And I would call my neighbors and say, neighbors, look, they're trying to shoot me. We got people. I didn't trust them. I really thought these cops came to hurt me. So I didn't trust them. See the guns? These are the kind of guns that came to get me with people. Those are the kind of guns they would chase me down with. No BS. Okay? I jumped a couple of fences. I climbed a garage. And I climbed a tree. And I was surrounded, so I gave up. And they pulled me down after the garage and banged my head against a metal, little metal, you know those jacks that people put their cars upon? Like, not jacks, but you know those little ramps, metal ramps? There was a pair of those under the garage and they pulled me down and banged my head against a thing. Almost, I seen stars, people. Okay, I seen stars. I was all cut up. You know what I'm saying? So I was hurt. And the cops still end up trying to break my arm in the police station, even though I wasn't resisting. Then they had enough to charge me with resisting arrest and disorderly conduct. So that's how I got this tape, because I demanded to see it. And people, I was supposed to go to trial on these two charges on October 30th, 2013. But trial was set for the month before that, and my attorney, who he appointed to me, he wouldn't even request this tape. He's talking about it doesn't exist. He asked for it and it doesn't exist. So I fired him. Then he wouldn't subpoena the U.S. Marshals and other evidence. So I fired him. I said, listen, if you cannot defend me how I want you to defend me, then withdraw from my case. So I fired him, and the court wouldn't give me any attorney, so I was pleased with that. So the court ordered that I had to represent myself. And people had demanded this tape and I got it. On my own, I got it. So you see, sometimes it's good. They say it's a fool have an attorney to represent himself. But sometimes you are a fool if you let people lead you to your hell. Okay? They are the embalmers. Some of these attorneys are embalmers. I'm going to tell you all the story of why they arrested me. The reason for. All because I fought against Wall Street. And they accused me of threatening to bomb a federal judge and a weasel attorney for Wall Street. That's why I'm under arrest. For intimidation, harassment, making threats, threatening to kill. That's what they charged me with.
It's all been in vain. Shall we resort to entreaty and humble supplication? What terms shall we find which have not already been exhausted? Let us not.
Okay, see they bring me out right there? See they bring me out right there? Okay. Now, let's get to the part where he's brutalizing me, then get to the part where he steals my money. Okay, people, this is from where, right? Watch what he's about to do to my hand, right? In my hand right here, I have on my red, green, and gold band. You know, it's a religious thing for me. What you all call religion? It's based on my Kemetic belief, on my African ancestry belief, okay? It's religion to you guys, okay? The point being, He's trying to rip this off my hand, and I've said to him, let me take it off? And you're gonna see what he did to me. I'm not resisting at all. But you're gonna see what he did to my wrist, okay? And how long he do it to my wrist. Okay, and question people. After this, right, ask yourself, would he do this to a Muslim? Would he do this to a Christian? Would he rip a bead across off of a Christian's hand on his neck? Would he rip an emblem of Muslim after Muslim after person who's wearing it? He won't, but look what he's gonna do to mine. Look. Look at this, people. See that? See what he did to my wrist? Look at what he's doing to my wrist. That's so unnecessary. Look at this. What he's doing to my wrist? See, we have my wrist. Just look. Look at that. See, we have my wrist. And y'all, do y'all see me resisting? I'm not even resisting. See, threw it off my hand, threw it over here. Look, am I resisting? Look how we have my wrist, people. See how we have my wrist in that fatal position? Look at that. And look how long he's gonna keep my wrist like that. Just look how long he's gonna keep my wrist bended like that. See him applying the pressure? Look. He's applying pressure on my arm. I'm in excruciating pain. See, I'm in pain. Look how we got my wrist, people. Just look at it. Police brutality. Violation of my Eighth Amendment right against cruel and unusual punishment. Look at that. And people, guess what? When I went to the jail, right, my wrist was so swollen. When they put me in Suffolk County Jail, my wrist was so swollen. I couldn't even move my fingers. My wrist was swollen. And I told them the cops did it. They didn't believe me. I even had to get x-rays, people. I got x-rays because I thought my wrist was broken. So I got proof. I got proof of this. I got x-rays. And I got medical report that showed my wrist was swollen, my fingers and everything was swollen. Look at him, he still had my wrist in that same position. It's been what, about 3 minutes now? So y'all see for yourself, police brutality, for what? To take my wristband off my hand. For what purpose? What purpose do you have to rip it off my hand like that for? And look what you're doing to me for no reason. Okay, now. You see that? Look. Hey, police, look at my wrist, police. Look how you have my wrist, police. Where the feds? Feds, are you all looking? Are you all looking how this guy have my wrist bended like this? Are you all looking? Okay, that's police brutality. You are looking, so you have my wrist in his hand? Look at that. Do you ask me resisting? Somebody gonna have to pay me for what a cop did to my hand and for my money that this cop stole. It's not over. I can't wait for the jury to see this video. People, I'm supposed to go to trial in December and the disorderly conduct and resisting arrest. The jury are gonna see this tape. Anyway, let me tell you all the story until the part come up where he steal my money. They accused me of threatening this federal judge and his wheels attorney, all because of my threat against Wall Street. I exposed them for their lies and for the mortgage fraud, because I discovered the mortgage fraud, so I sued them for it. And this is the cop here, Sharp. That's his name. That's the main one there, the main culprit. The main culprit right there. Anyway, they try to pay me out. They try to bribe me into dropping my lawsuit. I also filed a lawsuit against all the banks and against the government. They try to bribe me into dropping the lawsuit. They offer me $130,000 to fix my house up. They offer me $100 a month mortgage payment and money from my pocket. In return, I have to sign a release and shut up. I refuse. They couldn't buy me, so they sold me. Old pirates, yes, the rabbi. Sold I to the merchant ships. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit. Do you see how this guy have my hand? Do you see how he still have my wrist, people? Look, this guy been holding my wrist for about 10... How long now he been holding my wrist like that? How long have he been holding my wrist like that? How long have he been holding my wrist like that? So anyway, they couldn't buy me, so they sold me and built up all these false charges against me. So anyway, when the cops came to get me, I jumped out the window and I ran. Okay, people, here comes the thief, okay? Here comes the thief right now. See him coming through there? Okay. See, first thing, look at him. The first thing he's going to look at is the bag. Look at him. He's looking for the money. See him? He's looking for the money. Look at him. The money ain't there yet. Okay, people, here comes the money now. Here comes the money. There you go. I had much more money than that. But by the time I got to the police station, this is what I ended up with, right? Look at this. Look at him with my money. Look at him. Just watch his hand real carefully, okay? Watch how he's going to fold the money and put it in his hand. Look at it. Look. Keep your eyes on his hand, okay? Because he's very fast. You saw the folding money? Okay. Watch this. Watch his hands. See that he has some money wrapped up in his hand right there. Look, look. In his right hand. Look, see? He has money wrapped in his right hand. Look. Look, there he go. There he go, the money. In the trash can. He walked away. Put it in his pocket. Let's see that again. And people, they made him pay me restitution. They sent me a check for $40, saying he stole $40 from me. But how the heck they know it was $40? Okay, how they know it was $40? Because this other guy said it was $40. People, I didn't know he robbed me. Honest to God, I didn't know he robbed me. Because they like I said, our flock Adjoline, they had just got beaten up by them, so I wasn't thinking about no money. So I didn't know he robbed me. Even when I came out of jail 2 months later, they Lieutenant called me, he sent me a mail, and then a call, and he told me he wanted to see me. So I went to the police station, and he told me, I'm sorry to tell you, man, but one of our cops got caught stealing your money, and I'm embarrassed to tell you that. So he was very nice. He didn't have to tell me, because I didn't know. So look at it again. I'm going to show you all. See, he's playing card game with my money. He's going to fold it up, put it in his hand. Look, see? There it go. He just folded. There it go. He have two stocks in his hand. He opened one. The other one is already wrapped up in his hand. See? It's already there. Look. So what he's doing? He's playing slick. Look at his right hand. Look. There you go. See his hand? See? He got the money in his hand right there. The old thief. Babylon, your throne gone down. Babylon, your throne gone down. I told you all, anytime you all mess with me, I'm gonna bring you all down. I warned you all. Okay, I warn you all, I'm gonna bring you all down. We are messing with Paul L. Muckle. Y'all been warned.